Yeah.
How is that toxic? I love Chipotle. Are you kidding me, man? This is good stuff.
All right, we got a big crowd in here. I want everyone to be careful tonight. I mean, we packed it in. The fire marshals have been extremely nice, so I want you to be careful. The fire exits are this way and this way and this way. The concession stands for water back here and back here. All right, the bathrooms.
Of course.
I hope tomorrow to officially request that Chief Justice John Roberts reinstate the right for photo ID in our
Rudy Giuliani.
it's great to be here. It's great to be in North Carolina. You've got a great state. You've got a great governor. You've got an economy that is now being called the Carolina Comeback. And that economy is based on the principles that you will hear today from Donald Trump. It's based on common sense Republican principles of growth. Low taxes, low regulations. Put money back in your pockets instead of having the government take it from you. That's what Pat McCrory has done. That's what Donald Trump will do. So I know Pat for a long time. I knew him when he was mayor. He was one of the best mayors in the United States, and now he's the best governor, and he's a good friend, and you're lucky to have him. So, in November, when you elect Donald Trump president of the United States, campaigned for John McCain, and I've campaigned for George Bush, and I campaigned for Mitt Romney, and I've campaigned for Matt, and I've campaigned for myself, and I have never seen a crowd like this. It's unbelievable.
I'll tell you what, the message is the right message. We're tired of incompetence. We're tired of not taking care of our military. We're tired of not taking care of our vets who are being taken care of very poorly. We're tired of so many different things, and this is what happened. So our mayor, my friend Rudy Giuliani, just walks out of town and says, I don't believe this. This is incredible. And what he hasn't seen, and your governor, by the way, who's a great guy, and he's never seen. They're walking outside because there are thousands of people outside that can't get in. I said, Rudy, you think this is better? Go take a look outside. So I just want to thank Pat and Rudy, and I want to thank everybody for being here. And we're going to have a good time. We love North Carolina. We did really well in the primaries, if you remember. And I hear we're doing really well now. We have to win. That November 8th date is so important. It's so important. You know, I bring things up like the judges, right? Supreme Court justices. We have to get, you know, you can have as many as four. I guess there's a scenario in which this president could pick five Supreme Court justices. And if you pick two that are left, it's going to be a disaster for our country. Your Second Amendment, the National Rifle Association endorsed me, and they endorsed me early. They're great businesses, very much like Justice Scalia, and that's going to happen at some point. So for no other reason, I mean, such an important, one of the most important elections, for a lot of reasons, not just that, but for a lot of reasons, but that's so obvious, because for whatever reason, they say this could be the presidency, this next 4 years, where you'll pick more Supreme Court justices than anybody has ever had the opportunity to do, and believe me, I'll make you very proud of those justices. So we had an incident a few days ago with the $400 million all cash. $400 million all cash. Anybody know what that looks like? That's a lot of cash. That's a lot of cash. And honestly, it's so sad. Think of it. Going to Iran, a terrorist state. Now I happen to think they have plenty of money. We've given them $150 billion. So the $400 million is just, you know, I happen to think it goes into their accounts in Switzerland, personally. Now, a lot of people say, no, it's used for terror, and they use it for terror, because it's the number one terror funder, not even close. But I also think that when you have $400 million in cash, different denominations, you see the size of this? They did, I guess, release the pictures. After all, they released pictures. And interesting, I'll tell you, I sort of think it goes into bank accounts, right? You know, I sort of think they take it, they probably use some for this, some for that, you do a lot of things. And Obama said that he did it because we don't have a working account with Iran. Do you believe it? How long does it take to set up an account? Right? You don't have a working account, you set up an account, right, Laura? You set up an account, it takes about 2 minutes. Oh, good. What's going on in this country, folks, what's going on in this country is insane. And we have people running our country that don't know what they're doing. They're grossly incompetent. And it's time. I mean, we have to make change, real change, not Obama change. Whether it's Sergeant Bergdahl or we get Bergdahl, who was a traitor, and they get five of the greatest killers that they've wanted for 8 years. We get Bergdahl. I call it the 5-for-1 trade. Or the Iran deal, where we get nothing. We get nothing. They get, ultimately, they have the path. Beautiful path. They'll get way, way earlier than that. They'll get nuclear weapons. So if you get Trump, you're going to see a lot of changes to that deal. I saw where President Obama said that the $400 billion in cash was not, had nothing to do with the release of the hostages. It really doesn't work, does it? I mean, remember Obamacare? You're gonna keep your doctor, you're gonna keep your plan over and over again. You're gonna keep your doctor. It was a lie. And in fact, if he didn't make the lie, he would have never gotten approved because most Democrats, many of the Democrats didn't want to do it. It was only that that got them decided and to approve it. And it was a lie. And the $400 million, and from what the rumor is and from what the reports are, the hostages couldn't leave the airport until this other plane arrived. They don't know why, but I think we all have a pretty good reason why. It's all a big lie. It's all a big lie. And it's so sad to see, and let me tell you, Hillary Clinton is going to be 4 more years of Obama, but maybe worse. Maybe worse. It'll be 4 more years. 4 more years of ISIS. 4 more years of high taxes. You know, yesterday I had a big event, really. It turned out to be a very big event in Detroit. And very good. We got wonderful reviews and a lot of good comments, but the thing I'm doing, I'm cutting taxes bigly, especially for the middle class and especially for businesses. Because businesses are not, that means small businesses, businesses are leaving our country like they've never left before. They're going all over. They're going to Mexico, that I can tell you. Mexico is like the eighth wonder of the world. You know, I've been telling a story, a friend of mine, good friend of mine, good guy. He builds plants. He builds plants for cars, for computers, you know, where they make massive plants. And I said to him, how are you doing? And he's worked in North Carolina, by the way. I said to him, how are you doing? He said, phenomenal. It's like, I think, the biggest in the world at this. That's what he does. Great guy. I said, how's it going? He said, you got to see Mexico, dude. It's the eighth wonder of the world. What we're building there is like never has been built. We've never seen anything like it. And I said, how are we doing in the United States? I'm more interested in that, okay? It's okay, I guess. Well, you know, America first, folks, America. We get a little tired of these deals where they actually put, and you know why? Because of lobbyists, special interests, and people representing, and people wanting it to happen. It's just not that they want other countries to benefit over us. There are reasons for it. And you know, when I raise money, and I'm putting up a lot of money for my own campaign, I'm funding me, and I'm raising money for the Republican Party, and we're getting a lot of money from the small donors. Remember 2 months ago, I hadn't started. I wanted to make sure I get the nomination before I start, right? Let me get the nomination, please. And then I took a lot of heat from the press, the world's most dishonest people. Those cameras will not move and show how many people are in this auditorium. Those cameras are not going to move unless we have a protest. Is there a protester up there in the corner? We had a protest, that's the only time they move, because they're showing something that in their mind is a bad thing. So then they move, but I like that. I've always liked my protesters, because the cameras show these massive crowds, and people say, wow, was that a big crowd? And you know, I go home to my wife, I say, how's it going? She goes, darling, your speech was very good. Were there many people there? I say, about 7,000. That's a small group. It's only confined, I mean, you had to see outside. I felt so bad. I came up, thank you, and I love you too. Listen. But I came up with Rudy from New York, and we're driving up, and we're going block after block after block, the line. And I said, are those people going to be able to get in? They said, the place is already full. And Rudy just said, man, I've never seen anything like that. Maybe a couple of days before an election. But this is what's happening. Because of the fact we have a movement going, folks. Because people are so tired. What's with voter ID? Why aren't we having voter ID? I don't know words. I want to vote. Here's my identification. I want to vote. As opposed to somebody coming up and voting 15 times for Hillary. And I will not tell you to vote 15 times. I will not tell you to do that. You won't vote this game. But people will. They'll vote many times. And how that could have happened is unbelievable. And the governor just told me that they're going before the United States Supreme Court, Justice Roberts, and maybe they can get a stay. Let's see what happens. Okay. But I wrote a few things down, and to me, so important. Yes, darling, thank you. Unstable Hillary lacks the judgment. Now, Bernie Sanders said she lacks judgment, right? And nobody said anything about it, no problem. He said, you lack judgment. And during one of the debates, nobody said it. It was fun. When I say it, they say, that's terrible the way you talk. She does, she lacks judgment. She lacks temperament, and I'm the one that used unfit many, many months ago. And now they turn it around using on me. Unfit? I'm unfit. That's a first. But she lacks the temperament and the moral character to lead this country. Very simple. She really does. She's a dangerous person who doesn't tell the truth, which has been proven very loudly. I've never seen that. I don't think we've ever had greater proof of that. Of anybody. And she's disregarded the lives of Americans. You see what's happening with what she's done with her server. And you know why she did that. So I just look at this and I said that if she gets elected, she will cause the destruction of this country from within. Remember that. Remember that. You look at what's going on in the world. Look at France. Take a good look at France. I have friends that go to France. I used to love France. They say, no, thank you. They don't expect to be going back anytime for a long time. I have one friend that said, how was your trip this year to France? He said, France isn't France anymore. We're not going. And so many people are saying that. Look at what's going on with Germany. Look at what's happening with Germany. Look at the crime. Look at the problems. We have enough problems in our country. Right now, we don't need additional problems, folks. We don't need additional problems. And for all we know, this could be the great Trojan horse. This could be. We don't know who these people are. Now, they're coming in through Obama. And I looked at a chart yesterday, and it's like for years, it's sort of like this, a little uptick. And the last number, period of time, it's like, wah, wah, wah. They're, I have never seen anything like it. They're letting them in. And again, you can't vet them. You don't know where they come from. We don't know. Look at the damage that two people in San Bernardino probably radicalized the guy, the woman coming in. Look at the damage in Orlando. Look at the damage that was done in Orlando by one whack job, one sick whack job. And you know what he was screaming? He's screaming what they all scream. And we have to get smart, folks. Yeah. We don't need the problems. And we've already got those problems, just so you understand. Because they're coming into the country and they're being put where nobody even knows where they are. It's like, if I were the enemy, I would say, I can't believe they're that stupid. They're taking my people, and they're putting them all over the place. because you have great military right here. And our military... our military cannot be beaten. But you know what can happen? When we don't know where they are, where they're coming from, you get them all over the place. And folks, it's up. You don't need many. You don't need many. One person in Orlando, two people, look at France, 130. Now they have the strictest gun laws anywhere in the world. France, Paris, 130 people killed, 130. And I've said 100 times, if this man, or if this woman, or if that woman or man had a gun in Paris or at San Bernardino, you know, when the bullets were flying in the other direction, it would have been a whole different story.
Economic policies have produced 1.2%
economic growth, the weakest so-called recovery since the Great Depression. Now, this is like unbelievable, 1.2. You know, if China goes to 7% or 8%, it's like a national catastrophe. Now, what they do is they gut their currency, they devalue their currency, and bigly. And then all of our businesses continue to be drained out of the United States, our money, our jobs. They make our product, they sell our product to us. No tax, no nothing, you devalue. See, devaluing is sort of cheating, you know, it's sort of like cheating. Now, I have great relationships with China. I've done great business with China, I've done really well with China. I have these tenants, I sell condos, I own the Bank of America building in San Francisco with a group, a great group. Thank you, man. How do we go through our line? But it's cheating. It's really cheating. And when I look at these trade deals, it's so sad, where we lose $800 billion with a B, dollars a year on trade. With China alone, it's $400 billion and $500 billion and $505 billion. This is year in and year out. It's actually amazing that our country keeps going. But what has happened is we have people in the audience. In 18 years, they're making less money now than they made 18 years ago in real wages. 18. And in many cases, they're working two or three jobs. Okay? But they're making less money now than they made 18 years ago. And those stats come right out. Real wages. They're working harder. They're getting older. So in theory, it's supposed to be the other way. You know, you're working, you're young, you don't care. You're a little older, it's like, well, by the way, how about me? I think I'm working harder, too.